Ever heard of Vernier caliper? It is used to reduce human estimation error. In other words, a vernier caliper is a measuring device. It's used to precisely measure linear dimensions and it measures a straight line between two points. However, it is also a very useful tool to use when measuring the diameter of round objects like cylinders because the measuring jaws can be secured on either side of the circumference. Vernier calipers are super useful and a great tool to have in the toolbox. This instrument may be used to measure outer dimensions of objects using the main jaws, inside dimensions using the smaller jaws at the top, and depths using the stem. Vernier caliper was invented in 1631 by Pierre Vernier, who was a French mathematician and instrument inventor. He was inventor and eponym of the vernier scale used in measuring devices. Vernier caliper can measure accuracy to 1/100th of a millimeter and 1/1000th of an inch. With a vernier caliper, you can make more precise measurements than you could with regular rulers. On a vernier caliper, there are two types of scales. Vernier caliper least counts formula is calculated by dividing the smallest reading of the main scale with the total number of divisions of the vernier scale. LC of vernier caliper is the difference between one smallest reading of the main scale and one smallest reading of vernier scale, which is 0.1 mm or 0.01 cm. Formulae used in this topic are least count, density, and the volume of a body. Here's the diagram of vernier caliper. Thus, the main parts of a vernier caliper are internal jaws, external jaws, main arm, sliding arm, depth measuring probe, and locking screw. Preventing errors. Vernier calipers are delicate instruments and utmost care should be taken while handling them. It is also important that a vernier caliper is well calibrated before use. This means that when the movable arm is brought to its original or closed position, the zero on the main scale should exactly coincide with the zero on the vernier scale. This is extremely important as the caliper measures even the slightest deviation and thus might provide an inappropriate final reading. Scales. A vernier caliper has two main scales. One is known as the main scale and the other is the secondary scale, also known as the vernier scale. The secondary scale is the sliding scale, which moves over the main scale whenever the adjustable arm is moved. Both metric and inch measurements are provided on both of these scales. How to measure the diameter using vernier caliper? This figure shows a pair of vernier calipers being used to measure the diameter of a metal pipe. Reading on the main scale is 2.1 cm. Reading on the vernier scale is 0.07 cm. Therefore, the diameter of the metal pipe is 2.1 plus 0.07, which is equal to 2.17 cm. If the zero of the vernier scale is shifted to the right of zero on the main scale, then it is positive zero error. If the zero of the vernier scale is shifted to the left of zero of the main scale, then it is negative zero error. The formula of positive zero error is true reading equal to observed reading minus plus zero error. The formula of negative zero error is true reading equal to observed reading minus zero error. Stay home and stay safe. Like, comment and subscribe. Vibrant Relator signing off.